Nothing new today. Probably more of a educational tool rather than a playable game, but it's quite playable. I find it fun anyway. It's called Car Mechanic Simulator. You can do quite a bit with it. As I say, it's quite an educational thing if you don't know anything about cars, or even if you've got an interest in cars. It's been a while since I've played it, so can't remember whether I had a particular project on the go at the time, or whether I was just doing the missions, the story missions, people dropping off their cars. Obviously your phone goes apeshit as well with people getting in touch with certain problems with the cars. You can visit the junkyards and rescue and restore projects yourself. You can go to the car auctions and buy a car and kit it up and shit like that when you get more advanced, when you open up the pro tuning shop and stuff like that. I remember that. I just found a Cobra at the scrapyard in relatively good condition. Side pipes as well. Ooh. But we won't do that up for now, because I've just heard the phone bleep. So we'll have a look what's what. See what I mean? There's quite a few people with certain issues with their cars. They'll only stick around for a few minutes. Or you can continue with the story. What's the story? Looks like a BMZ 4. FMW Roadster. On my way back from a party, and I believe I might have hit a rather large pothole or something, please assess the damage and make any necessary repairs. This car belongs to my father-in-law. Trying to get it all fucking sorted before daddy finds out and tans your ass. Okay, so we'll take on that story mode. Challenge. And we'll see what's wrong with this road. Oh, it looks like the Cobra. Similar colour. Does look like the Z4 or Z3, whatever. Alright, so we'll send it for a start to the test path, which should give us a better idea of what we're looking at. Okay. Run it onto the first brake test, which is the fronts. So the front left brake is fucked. The rear left brake is fucked, so the brakes are shot down the left hand side. Test the suspension out. Again, the front left suspension is shot to shit. And the rear left suspension is knackered as well. Not as bad as the front, but it's still knackered. Suspension arm, shock absorber, brake discs, yeah, we knew all that. Lower suspension arm, spring cap, the bushings. Both bushings. Shocks, suspension arm, shock cap. Yeah, pretty much standard. If you fucking hit a pothole, it's fucked. Usually anything that's bad, as you can tell from the wheels on this side, to the wheels on this side, which are all rusted and corroded to fuck, is usually a good sign that there's something wrong with it. Send it to... In fact, we'll take it to test track as well, just in case it throws up any other problems that we might miss on the initial diagnostic. So we'll take it to the test track. Take it for a little buzz around the test track, a little whip around. See what we will see. Brakes are definitely shot to shit. Handling's not much better either, so that's obviously a good sign that the suspension's fucked. This'll be the test of it. Oh yes. Bouncing everywhere like a gazelle on steroids. Probably gonna have to stop well before the brake line. Hi Logichard 899, how you doing? Hope all's well today. So yeah, that car is definitely in need of some serious repairs. You okay man, you had a good day? Ah, see now that's thrown up three new faults that weren't originally on the diagnosis. So the inner tie rod's fucked, the outer tie rod's fucked, and so is the actual drive axle. Okay, so we send it to the lifter. And we've got the Cobra in lifter B, so we'll have to move to lifter A. Get them wheels off for a start. Yeah, the brakes and the suspension shot to shit. Looks like the radiator's fucked as well. And the exhaust. Yeah, exhaust pipe's fucked. So's the rear muffler. The rest of the engine looks spot on. The coilovers there are obviously knackered. Parts not discovered. So with that... Where's the test? There we go. Use every tool that we have to our disposal. Find out what it's saying. Throttle body's fine, starter motor's fine. Apparently the radiator's fine as well. Oh no, the fan housing is fine. The radiator itself could well and truly be knackered. Do a compression test. Check the engine itself. Which all seems fine. OBD scanner. See what faults it's throwing up. Again, nothing electrical. And the final one, fuel pressure test. It's all looking well. Yep, not an issue. So we know that the engine is mechanically sound. If anything, it's all superficial. So let's get it up. Get underneath it and have a look. Right, so The exhaust is fucked. The rear muffler's fucked. Suspension. Lower suspension arm. Sway bar. Coilovers, discs. Calipers, brakes themselves. It's basically seen better days, this car. Take the caliper off. Oh, the brake shoe's actually fine. The disc isn't. The wheel hub's fucked. The wheel hub bearing's fine. Outer tyre rod's knackered, yeah, we knew that already. Right, what am I needing to take the... Oh, the bushings. Sway bar front end link looks fine. Probably the one part of the suspension that is actually fine. Right, so that's the left-hand side stripped. Wheel hub cap looks fine. Wheel hub bearing looks fine. That caliper's knackered. That brake pad's fine. That brake disc isn't. Rear wheel hub's fine. So is the actual wheel hub itself. Sway bar, rear link, looks fine. Rear suspension upper arm looks fine. Rear shock cap, rear spring's fine. Spring cap is knackered. That bushing looks fine. Try and repair as many parts as we can. Rear shock is knackered. Need to take the bushings out before it'll let me take the sway bar off. Suspension arm cross member. Just a dream. Anything else looking out the ordinary? You alright, Hades? Still there. Rear suspension arm. Take that bushing out. Rear axle knuckle. Alright, let's see what we can repair. Successful repair. See if we can repair the muffler and the exhaust pipe. Evidently not, which I mean we're gonna have to buy new parts. Just out of curiosity, repair with a minimum part condition 100%. Still something undiscovered. I know what it is. Yeah, the fan housing's fine, but the radiator's not. We need a new radiator. So, if we type in rad, and it's that one there, radiator A. Now that undiscovered part should be the radiator, which it is, radiator A. Alright, so what we can do now, obviously, is mount the new radiator. The same radiator fan housing that we've just repaired. All nice, new and shiny. Whack it back up on the lifter. And we'll start with the rear. Right, everything should be fixed. Except the exhaust. Rear knuckle housing. Rear suspension arm with two new bushes. Rear suspension arm bait. Need to buy one of them. Which is that one there. The faster I will run. Yep. Two new bushes and... As I say, if you don't know anything about cars, but you're interested, you might find it educational, you might find it boring. I actually quite like it myself. Rear suspension arm, so we need to order one of them as well. It should be here since we're under suspension. Was it A? Rear suspension arm A, was it? No, rear suspension arm. Which is that one? That also needs a bushing. Shock. So we need a shock absorber as well. Which isn't a problem. Rear shock A. Brand spanking new one. As far as the suspension goes, I think that's everything. Wheel hub, that was repaired. Rear wheel hub. New brake disc. Brake pads were fine, if I remember rightly, yeah. They were 80-odd%. So they can go back on. New brake caliper and piston. pub Burham was fine as well, if I remember. Yep, there they are, 88%. They were fine. Wheel hub cap, put a brand new one of them on anyway. And before we put the wheel back on, we'll move over to the exhaust. And it was asking for exhaust pipe and rear muffler. What the fuck is that? Rear muffler 14. Okay. So we look for exhaust pipe and muff. Looking for a muff. Rear muffler 14. So we whack a new pipe on. New muffler. No, not the performance one. Stick the rear tyre back on. In fact, no, the rim's shot to shit. Both the same size. 18 inch, 225, 40 yards. Right. So we take the tyres off first. Let's see if we can restore these rims rather than buying. That's the thing with this game. If you've got to buy new parts, it can be costly. You get your money back, because obviously we get a discount in the shop. But if you can repair the parts, if you've got a decent enough repair level, you'd end up making a shitload of money. So let's take these back over to the repair bench. And we can repair them, hopefully. No, that one's bust. And there was only the one that we could repair. Bollocks. So, if we install a tyre, and what were the Rim Classic 6? With vintage tyres. Were they? No, they were sports tyres. So we're looking at Rim Classic 6, 18 inch, 225, 14 hours. So we want to come out of the parts, go to rims. Where are they? Rim Classic 6, 18 inch, and we want two of them. We should be able to mount the old tyres on, because there was fuck all wrong with the tyres. It was the rims themselves. Yep. So we take the tyre off there, balance it. Fuck, oh, I'm too far away. Yeah, balance that one whilst this one is getting done. Normally does like three passes on the wheel balancer. Balance the both of them. And that's the third pass. It was done. So we take that one off. Go and work on the front suspension. that, so we need a front steering knuckle there. So come out of the rims, go back into tuning parts. And we're looking for knuckle, which is that one. Yep, got a brand new one on there for them. Ah, front shock was shot to shit as well. But for that, we need to separate the old spring and the old shock on the spring puller. Take it from the spring compressor, see if we can repair it. No, I don't think so. So we need a front shock absorber A and a front... we just need a front shock absorber A because I've got springs and I've got spring caps. So we're looking for a shock. That one there. Straight away, join parts, brand new one of them with a brand new one of them and a brand new one of them. Thank you very much. And because it's a complete unit now, from the spring compressor, which is already set up, you should be able to just... Yep, there we go. Right, so whack the front axle cover on. We need the sway bar front hand link. And the one that you had on there was fine, at 88. He hadn't done anything to that. We need the inner tie rod and outer tie rod put on first. They were both brand new, because I repaired them. So there's the outer tie rod as well. Lower suspension arm, sure I repaired that, yeah. Two brand new rubber bushings for them. Did I take the upper suspension? Nope, didn't take the upper suspension arm off. That was off the rear. So the wheel hub, that was repaired as well. And use the front wheel bearing. I think that was at like 80 odd percent too. Yeah, 88. Brand new brake disc, because that was repaired. His brake pad was fine, that was at 80 odd percent as well. Yeah, 88. All seems to be 88 with this car. Brand new brake caliper since we repaired that. And a piston. Front drive, the axle was fucked and we couldn't repair it because it bust. So if we look for another axle, and we need a front drive axle H, which is that one there. Whack the new rim on there that we've just fixed. Job done. Just double check it all. Rear shock absorber cap. Right. Mark all these up. See, this is another feature. If you find anything that you've missed, mark it with a star, get it back up on the lifter and it'll tell you exactly where it is. So rear shock absorber cap, where are we missing that? as it's saying. Take that portion out. Put a brand new one in. So one of them should have now turned green that I've got a star on. Which is that. So take that off. And there's another rubber bushing somewhere that we're missing. Which is at the front here. Put a brand new bush in there. That one's fucked as well. They are the bane of your existence when it comes to fitting up cars, because they're so easily missed. Alright, so there should now be two more rubber bushings that are green, that one and that one. Classic rim 6, spring cap and a rear cap. Take all this apart again, brake cap off, caliper, brake pad, wheel hub cap. Wheel hub bearing. Take the brake disc off, rear wheel hub off. Take the wheel hub free off. To get to the suspension. Rear suspension cross member. Take all of this off. Rear sway bar. suspension armor. Fit everything back together as it should be. Brand new spring cap. Need a new rear spring. Normally got a shitload of them. New shock absorber cap. No, not a performance one, just a bog standard one. In fact, I'm gonna take that off since he wants 100%. That's what he's getting. So we'll buy a shitload of them as well. Sway bar, rear end link. There's fuck all wrong with that, so that can go back on. Rear suspension arm. Don't forget the bushing. Wheel hub 3. The rear wheel hub. Wheel hub bearing, which was at 80% odd, but there was nothing wrong with that. He didn't want that fixing. The brake disc, brand new. The brake pad, 88%. The brake caliper and the caliper piston, brand new. The rear wheel hubcap. Should allow us to fit the rear rim, which again has been sorted. Now technically, just check it all over. Rear suspension arm B. Yeah, everything else that was starred is all sorted. Except for that. So let's have a look. That's because you never installed it, you soft twat. Now what are you saying? I figured as much. Yep, everything sorted. So we drop her down off the lift. Daddy's car's all fixed. Send her to the door. And we'll go and test her again on the track. And now let's see how she handles. So yeah, she's going to be a lot better since we've just done all the run and repairs. Oh yeah, handles a lot better because of the suspension fix, brakes a lot better. wing. Front windscreen. Rear right door. Front right door window. Right side mirror, that's come off with the door anyway. Rear left door window, that's come off with the door. Rear right door. Oh no, rear left door window hasn't come off. The front left door, yeah. Rear right door, yeah. Front left fender, front window. Trunk window. The boot window. Front right door window. Yeah, that's off. Right side mirror. Rear left door window and a rear right door window. Yeah, well they're all off. So now, Royal Bianco. See if we can repair them parts first. No, I didn't think so. I'm sure you can't, you can only repair engine parts on the repair bench. I'm pretty sure of it. I'm sure you need another tool to repair bodywork panels. I think it's the welding tool. So basically we just order new ones, but we need to come to the home menu, go to the body shop. What are we? Royal Bianco, weren't it? Yep. And we need front left door, rear right door. So front left door. Rear right door. Front left fender, windscreen, boot window. So we need a front left wing, which is that. New windscreen. New boot window, whatever the fuck that is. There it is. Front right door window and right side mirror. Front right door window. Right side mirror. Bollocks. Front right door window, right side mirror. We need a rear left door window and a rear right door window. And then we should be good to go. Rear right door window. Rear left door window. And then it's just a case of assembling all the parts. Brand new, different colour, but they're not asked about that. Front left door window. Ah, what was the percentage on that? 73. He didn't ask for a front left door window, so even though it's below the 74%, See, the mirror isn't. Front left wing. Rear left window, brand new. Front window, brand new. Right side mirror, brand new. Front right window, brand new. Rear right door, brand new. And the glass. And the last one was the boot window, weren't it? Yep. And that's another job finished. So, it's cost us just over £2,000, and we're making 2,300. So that's another order finished. Eventually, I will start this Cobra project, but since it was a scrapyard find, as you can see, the entire engine is shot to shit. That needs to come out there and get over on the engine stand over there. But I'll need the engine crane over there to lift it out. I'll just have a look underneath it. I'm willing to bet everything's shot to shit under there. Oh yeah, gearbox, oil pan, cross member, suspension, yeah, the whole thing needs to be fucking stripped down and repaired and rebuilt, but that'll be one for another episode. Albeit I want to repair this Cobra because it's going in my garage. It doesn't actually start, I don't think. Move it to the door, see if we can jump in it and start it. It was in a barn. It was a barn find. No. So. Send it back over to the car lift. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to see if there's any decent cars going through at the car auctions. I might try one of them barn finds as well, see if I can find another one. But it'd have to be something exceptional for me to... I'm talking like a Toyota Supra or a Ferrari or a McLaren or something like that. I'm not going to take anything less. No. Next car, please. Miavani. I've never heard of that one. It's a 4x4. No. The Mayan M3. I'm sure that's a BMW M3. No. Nope, don't want a 4x4. I've already repaired a Sakura GT20. So don't want to do another one. I've already repaired an Atlanta, I don't want one of them. All of these cars are coming through with major rust on them. So, I could probably find better at a junkyard. Now that looks like the old Pontiac Firebird. And I've already done one of them as well. So no. The Chieftain, I know is shit. Doesn't fetch much money, so I'm not gonna fucking do one of them. If it was a Hellcat, I might think again. No, they're all coming with fucking rust on them. I'd probably be better off finding a barn conversion or go in the junkyard and seeing what's there. Bolt chap and ethanol, no, it's a load of shite. It's not worth anything. I want a car that I can do up and make some money off. And it's another Katagiri Katsumoto. So, no, fuck off. Even though it's in good nick. Well, that was a waste of $200. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll go to the junkyard first. See if I can come across another one of them rare finds. A bit like that Cobra that's sat in the garage at the minute. And if I can't find anything at the junkyard, I'll have a quick look at one of the barns. Cost you $500 to go to the junkyard. But I've got a shitload of money there, so it's not like I'm going to be missing out on any. The junkyard is usually hit and miss. Sometimes you'll find some decent cars there, sometimes it's just a load of shite. But all the piles of junk lying around, you can usually find parts there at least that you can sell on. Like the likes of this. Research it. There we go, we found a wheel hub bearing. Nothing in that. Nothing in that. Unless it's in decent nick, it's not worth taking. You can't repair it. Tell you what I'll do. I'll have a scout round the junkyard first. And then I'll pick up any parts that I can find. Well, that's disconcerting straight away, because there's usually a decent card at the back, or there's usually a decent card underneath this barn. But to have nothing there. I'm seeing a Pontiac Firebird there. But it looks in an absolute shit state. And it is. It's completely fucked. You want something that's either got decent interior or decent bodywork. You need that platform to start with. I'm not buying a Chapman the shite. Something's telling me this was another wasted journey. And it was. They're the only two cars in the whole scrapyard. A new seat. See, occasionally you do get that rare find in these as well, where you'll end up with either an unopened chest or an entire engine, which will sell for a shitload. That door was alright at the bottom. But again, if it's yellow or if it's not at least green in the high percentages, it's not worth taking. A rear windscreen for the Typhoon. Oh no, it's a front windscreen. Fucking find out a lot of seats. Sway bar. bad mirror. See the likes of that. A V8 and a V8 head. If I was to get either of them in decent condition, you're probably looking at near on a grand. Decent steering wheel. No, I'm not taking that fucking Pontiac Firebird. Take that taillight though. For an M3. Serpentine belt. Oh, I never even spotted this. Is that an old Pontiac Trans Am? IE kit. Knight Rider. It's definitely got the shape. But it's fucked. Only decent thing is the frame. Yeah, that big V8 block's knackered. Oh well, that's a bit soul destroying. Never even spotted that stashed away behind here. Wasted journey. So I'll do a barn find in a minute. Ah, another barn location. We will take that. Taillight. We're virtually right back at the start. I'll just check these last few piles. No, not looking good. Oh, hang on. Retro wheel hub. And a gearbox. Ha ha. That'll sell for a fair bit of money. Alright, well that was a bust. So some of that's worth a pretty decent amount of money. That gearbox will set me back 720 odd quid. Once it's repaired, You're probably looking at near on a grand. So we'll buy them, head back to the garage, and do a quick barn find. Right, so, barn finds all over the fucking map. So do the one on the coast there. That looks like a little Renault Clio. And surprisingly good nick too. Is that an old Cadillac? They're all very custom. That's in remarkable condition. The hood. Another rim. That looks more like the Trans Am that we've just seen. $32,000. $35,000. And $27,000. So the little Renault is probably what we're going to get more money for. But again, it's nothing spectacular. So, I think we'll just cut our losses. Plus, it's going to be a full restoration. And I've already got a full restoration on the cards. It would have to have been something remarkable. Something completely mind-blowing in order for me to take it. To fill up that last car left of space. So with that being said, I think I'm gonna end it there for now. Just check whether I've got a level up. No, I haven't. No available skill points. To buy any more perks. I want to open the paint spray booth if I can. But for now I'm going to end it there. As I say, it's more of a like an educational tool than a game, but I find it quite enjoyable myself. Hope you've enjoyed it yourselves. Whether you're into cars or whether you're not, it could teach you a thing or two. Gives you some insights as to the workings behind the car. I actually find it quite enjoyable. I mean, I like toying around with cars. I've had several. I've done a lot of the work on them myself. Even if you don't, it's not that accurate. You know, if you don't find it that accurate when it comes to fixing cars, it gives you an idea of the workings and what problems could arise and how to fix them, how to take them apart. Failing that, YouTube and Google are probably your best friends when it comes to any kind of issue with cars. There's always some video on YouTube. Someone will give you step-by-step instructions on how to fix any issues. You just Google that issue that you're having with your car, and there'll always be somebody there giving you a step-by-step demonstration of how to take it off the car and how to repair it. Which is probably one of the reasons why games like this sort of interest me. But I'm hoping to feature a lot more of this, whether you like it or, you know, you can tolerate it, because I'm determined to get my levels up to a certain degree. Where does I actually unlock the spray booth? Ah, there we go, level 30. So I've got 10 more levels to go. Adds another paint shop, adds a dyno, and another lift into the garage. So I've got a few more perks to choose before I hit level 30. But I'll get there. I will get there. Right, so I shall be ending it for now, and I shall be streaming again in just a brief moment with another favourite game of mine, which again a lot of people have asked, wow, what is that game? Sniper Elite 3, which I did a video on last night. And I hope, again, you enjoy that as much as I enjoy playing it. But for now, that's the end of Car Mechanic. And I hope you've enjoyed it. But if you bear with me, I shall see thee again real soon. Like, within 5 minutes soon. Take care, guys. Thanks for joining me.